Now the Blue Jackets trying to get away again, work it in down low. Myers is still out there. He has not been able to get to the bench. Ennis tapped it, didn't get it out. Kept in with a shot right on, and Miller makes the save and covers up. Quick shot, and that's steered away in front of the net and recovered by Buffalo, and now the pass up on the wing, and here's a break. Rolling in on goal, Ennis cutting in on goal, a shot right on, the rebound, they jam at it, they score!
With his great speed, looked like he had lost the puck and got too far down the ice and will be unable to cut in. But watch this, from an impossible angle, he doesn't beat the goalie, but the puck's there, and Jochen Hesch taps in a two-footer.
And you got three Columbus defenders playing the puck. One of those guys has got to eliminate Jochen Hesch. They didn't. They were all fishing for the puck, and he was able to find it.
Kept in by the Blue Jackets, trying to feed it in front. Hesch takes it away. Hesch coming back with Coletta, 2-on-2. Hesch in over the line, in for Coletta. He took the shot right on the rebound. That's tipped just wide of the net. And Coletta got wiped out. The net got wiped out. The goaltender got wiped out.
And the puck did not go in the net, as Coletta went to the net with some enthusiasm and couldn't find the handle as the puck was available.
Yeah, it got bouncing on him a little bit there at the side of the net.
Back it comes for Myers again, holding it in. Myers, and Roy, Myers, one-timer, right in front of the net. Caron has saved the rebound, they score! Jason Pominville, and finally the population grows in Pominville. Pominville taps it home on the power play. 2-0 Buffalo.
Pominville gets his second of the year and some real good work on the power play to keep the puck in the zone, and the Sabres moved it around nicely. And Pominville, coming off the left wing, patiently waits for the puck and then has a wide open net.
Coletta, pass back through the middle again, in over the line, knocked down at the blue line, and now Columbus trying to come back again. And Coletta came over and hammered his man, Umberger.
Coletta, he makes sure Umberger isn't going where he wants to go.
Finally chipped ahead by Russell and taken. Now here's a 2-on-1 for Columbus. Getting it over the line. The pass across to Clark with a shot. Miller makes the save, and then he covers up.
That was a lengthy 2-on-1. A line change by Buffalo created the odd man, and here it comes. Early pass across and a bad angle shot that Miller handled with ease. The rebound was available, but not for long.
Came back to the point. Tootin with a shot. That's right on. The rebound swept away, but not out. Tootin keeping it in there. Tootin with another shot, deflects in front of the net, and Miller makes the save and hangs on to it. And the red light is going on, and why is it on?
The puck,
was nowhere near crossing the goal line.
It went in after the whistle.
After the whistle, yeah, but it doesn't count after the whistle.
It's a high stick there by Chris Clark, and that's why the whistle goes.
That goes in behind the net. Tipped out in front, came all the way back to Tootin with a shot. He scores! No goal! No goal! Goaltender interference.
Yeah, Morrow came pushed. He got pushed through by a Sabre, but he made contact with Ryan Miller and caught it from behind and put him down. Good call by the ref.
And Vanek couldn't get it in front. Vanek wheels it back to Myers. He gives it to Vanek. Vanek rolling it beside the goal. Back and the shot. They score!
Some real good passing on that power play, and Buffalo gets the second power play goal of the night, and Stafford, playing his first game after missing a lot with a bad shoulder from the angle there, makes no mistake, sticking it up over the goaltender to make it 3-0 Sabres.
Back, Adam wins the draw, getting it on to Stafford out in the slot. Pominville right beside the net to Adam, and Garon covers up, and Adam now mixing it up beside the net with Clark, but I think everything is going to cool.
Adam couldn't get enough mustard on that shot, or he might have had a goal.
His stick goes carried. Now it comes back to the blue line, but it's kept in there. Around to Nash again. Nash trying to twist around. Got it in front. And a shot by Umberger hit the side of the net. R.J. Umberger had a great opportunity in front of the net, but Miller came across and took away the short side on him. We talk about Rick Nash being a monster hockey player. Well, how about Nathan Gerby? He does the monster mash as he steps into him. You're going down, big fella. Take that one. Voracek trying to knock the puck free, and now we've got a battle going on up near center ice. It's Commodore going with McCormick. McCormick and Commodore, and McCormick threw a bomb. He just unloaded with a bomb and dropped Commodore in his tracks. It's all over.
Well, Commodore's going to need a shoehorn to get his helmet off after taking that punch.
Yeah, great job by Cody. You know, Commodore is a man that hit Coletta from behind. You know what? Cody's job on this team is to look after his guys on the ice. The first chance he had, he went out to send a message to Commodore. That's not going to happen here. And if it does, we're not going to tolerate it. So I give him an awful lot of credit. And this is the kind of thing you want to see with a team. This pulls a team together right here, guys.
Commodore got a five-minute penalty for hitting Coletta from behind into the boards earlier. And that little hit was not forgotten by Cody McCormick.
Monador trying to tie it up along the boards. Cap free. Rolled around again and sent back to Russell. Russell holding it in. Russell cleared it in front of the net. Miller came out to make the save and hang on to it.
Umberger missed on the pass and got absolutely nothing on the shot. It was a soft shot. They call it a nudist shot. It had nothing on it.
With McKenzie, it comes free and taken back by Pominville, who gets it across to Stafford. Stafford swings it in over the line, but the pass was behind Adam. Stafford going after it again, and he gets nailed against the boards heavily, and he is not getting up. Drew Stafford still on the ice, and now we've got Bohl, who hits Stafford, being challenged by a couple of the Sabres, including Montador. Yes. Bohl makes his money doing this. Montador just trying to hang on, and the linesman, well, they started in, and then they backed off, and now they're going to get in. Meanwhile, Stafford is trying to shake it off.
And Stafford is playing his first game after coming back after hurting his shoulder, and you got to hope that is not a problem for him here.
It was. That just goes to show how valuable Steve Montador is. You know, the guy, we've talked about him tonight, his plus minus, how well he's played. He sticks up for his players. The guy can fight. He does a lot of things that people may overlook, but he's done a nice job here so far this year.
Back for Weber. Weber will flip it on in. And now we've got a battle breaking out between the benches.
Take over, Rob, take over.
I've got two gloves in here so far.
One is Coletta, and the other one is Dorsett. And now they start to fire punches at one another. Coletta and Dorsett. Dorsett got the first few in, and then Coletta came back with a vengeance. He's running out of steam with those lifts that he's pounding in there, and finally they'll break it up.
That could
Roll lay. Down go the two linesmen.
That could be the most left-handed punches in one fight in a long time in the NHL.
That's a great job by Pat. After he made that hit initially early in the game, he's taken an awful lot of verbal abuse from Columbus here and was challenged pretty much all night. He picked the right time, the right place to get back, and he did a fine job of it.
Hey, what, Dorsett got some in early, but he was catching late.
Count them up. How many lefts? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. I don't know how many, but quite a few, and at least half of them landed. If Dorsett didn't know Coletta was a southpaw, he knows now. And Lindy doesn't agree with what the message Derek Roy brought from the referees.
No, I think it's a situation where they're making a call on Pat Coletta here.
He's got 2, 5, and 10.
He shouldn't get extra minutes for winning the fight, should he?
That's knocked down and over the line. I beg your pardon. Came in front of the net, is kept in there. Dumped out in front, the shot right on. Miller makes the save. Russell gains the line. He flipped it back for Tootin. Tootin's intercepted. Here's a breakaway for Stafford, walking in on goal backhand. And the save is made by Garon. And Garon went flying into the boards as well. Garon on into the corner to hit it. He gets it up the middle, but that's broken up by Morrison. Morrison coming in over the line. Morrison trying to clear it in front of the shot. They score! Tyler Ennis on a perfect pass from Morrison. Tyler 2 puts it away. 4-0 Buffalo.
Well, it was a gorgeous pass by Morrison, who would have had a good chance to score himself, but elects to pass it. Gets the pass by Strahlman, the one defenseman, and Ennis made no mistake. 4-0 Buffalo.
Manning on to Weber, came off the skate, and is picked up and brought back by Bohl, who knocks it down the ice and chases in after it along with Morrison. And Morrison took a hit from Bohl, who's going to get another penalty. And that one's to the head, I thought. He's getting tossed.
Yes, he is. With 2:47 to go, it's more than a minor.
It sure is. He's being waved by the referee. Get your butt to the dressing room.
Yeah, he's coming over to explain to the bench that it was a hit to the head. That's why he's going.
Well, he may be hearing from Toronto, and I don't mean the Maple Leafs. Ennis swings it back for Pominville. Pominville guiding it across ice. Roy Ennis, clear to the in front, they score! Thomas Panik just takes the pass from Ennis, taps it in. 5-0 Buffalo.
Another power play goal. That's 3 of the 5 by Buffalo. What a pass by Ennis. And I know on the 5 days off, on at least 3 of them, the Sabres practiced the power play with some enthusiasm, and it certainly looks like it paid off, doesn't it?
Hest rolling it back to the point. Hest has got it again. He's going to have to shoot over to Ennis. He didn't shoot. The rebound, Pominville. He cleared it right through the goal crease. And it's swept away as the buzzer will end the game.
And Ryan Miller gets his first shutout of this season. 19-shot perfect game by the goaltender, and that is a strong game played by Buffalo.
Hopefully we can keep this going, because, I mean, we talked a lot about scoring goals, but if our power play gets going, I mean, everybody's going to find a way to score more, and it can just help our team in the long run.
It might be as good a game as we've played in our building. Emotion-wise, from handling the puck-wise, special teams, I thought the penalty killing was fabulous. The power play did a real nice job, so it was a complete package.
It was great what Cody did. It was great with what Patty Coletta did, Monty, Leo. I mean, guys stuck up for each other, and I mean, it's fun to see. I mean, we're a tight team, and when things like that happen, everybody's got to be in there. And I mean, it's definitely exciting on the bench, and I mean, everybody saw the reaction in the crowd, so it makes it even more exciting.